Let's get started on creating the forecast analytic within AF Analytics to predict dryer generation times. From the Windows taskbar, open Pi System Explorer and be sure you're connected to the dryers database. First off, we will be using an AF table to store the coefficients of our linear regression lines from the previous section. Navigate to the library and the dryer data table under Tables. The table and the coefficients for each dryer's equation have already been built out for you. Take a moment to confirm that these are correct. We will be creating an AF analytic for the forecast equation at the template level for the dryers. Navigate to the library and the dryer template under Element Templates. Click on the Analysis Templates tab and click on the New Analysis Template option. Name your new analysis template My Dryer Regeneration Cycle Time Forecast. This analysis has already been built out under the name Dryer Regeneration Cycle Time, but we want you to be able to build out the expression on your own. By default, you have created a new expression type analysis, and this is exactly what we need. We will be creating a multi-line analysis utilizing the multivariable capability of AF Analytics. The first step in our analysis is to find the last drying event. We will be making use of new AF Analytics functions that allow for array calculations. Let's use the recorded values by count function to grab the past 10 states of the dryer. Create a variable called past 10 states and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation will create an array of 10 values consisting of the past 10 states the dryer has had. To view the output of the operation, click on Evaluate and hover your mouse over the blue information symbol next to the evaluation. We now want to filter this array to only capture the states where the dryer is in drying mode. Create another variable called past drying states and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation will create an array of filtered values consisting of the past drying phases and their associated timestamps. Let's grab the most recent drying event. Create a new variable called last drying event and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation grabs the timestamp of the first value in the past drying states array, or the most recent drying phase's associated timestamp. Next, we want the analysis to check how long the dryer has been in the drying state. Create a new variable called hours into drying cycle and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation will output, in hours, the length of time that the dryer has been in the drying phase. Finally, we want to input our forecasting equation. Create a new variable called forecasted regen cycle duration and input the formula you see on your screen. This operation first checks that the dryer is in the drying phase, and if it has been in the drying phase for longer than 10 hours. If those conditions are met, it then applies the coefficients from our linear regression model stored in the dryer data table previously created. Otherwise, if the initial conditions aren't met, then the forecast is not performed. Remember, we only want this prediction to be made when the dryer is in the current drying phase. Something to note here is why did we add the condition in the previous equation to check if the drying phase has been longer than 10 hours? Remember that during our modeling, we filtered out event frame data where any drying cycle durations were shorter than 10 hours. It's important to account for these filters in your prediction logic. The dryer template has already been configured to have an attribute named My Forecasted Regeneration Cycle Time Forecast, which point to pie tags that already exist for dryer elements dryer A and dryer B. To the right of the expression field under Output attribute, click the map link and assign the My Forecasted Regeneration Cycle Time Forecast template attribute for the forecasted regen cycle duration variable. Also note that the example element for this template has been set to dryer A. This means that all evaluations and preview calculations will be done using dryer A data. You can change to another element by clicking the link and selecting a different one, for example, dryer B. Check in your changes by clicking Check In at the top of Pi System Explorer. We now have our complete analysis, which is forecasting the duration of the regeneration cycle using the drying cycle barrels of the preceding drying phase as our predictor. Your complete analysis should look like the one on the screen and should evaluate as you see. You can also use the Preview Results feature of AF Analytics to confirm that the analysis is functioning. You can do this by right-clicking on your analysis and clicking on Preview Results. In the lower left-hand corner of Pi System Explorer, select the Management view. Here is where you manage all the asset analytics configured for an AF database. This includes enabling, disabling, and backfilling calculations. Select the My Dryer Regeneration Cycle Time Forecast analysis for dryer A and B elements. On the right-hand side under Operations, click Enable. Once the green checkmark appears in the status column, the analyses are up and running. Again, under Operations, click on Queue. This exposes the backfilling configuration dialog. Configure the start and end times to be *-7D and *, respectively. And finally, click on Queue to start backfilling results for the two dryers.